Very good morning, children. Yesterday we studied about separation of mixtures. So one more part is remaining is purification of water. In cities, especially in cities, what happens? Water is purified. Because already the water which is going from all household, again it is going to back to the filtration tank where it is in the filter bed generally we call. From there they will again recycle it, refilter it, and they purify it, send it. But what are the processes there? Because impure water is not good for health. Contaminated water is not good for health. So what is done here? There is a simple technique. Okay. First, the water is carried to a one tank, big tank. Okay. So first of all, the complete water is sent here, impure water. Okay. So this is first, it's called sedimentation tank. Sedimentation tank. So what happens here? It is impure water. Okay. So it's a purification of water. Purification of water. So first of all, the impure water is made to flow to the one tank called sedimentation tank, where all the solid particles will settle at the bottom. So solid particles will settle at the bottom. Okay. Again, from there, from this tank, it is supplied to one more tank. So this tank is called loading tank. It's called what? Loading tank. Here, what about suspended particles? The low weight particles which are present suspended here, they are removed. They are removed. So loading tank is where the which are not dissolved or which are not under the water, they will be floating. So that is removed. Okay, this part. So again, still the water is impure. Still the water is impure. Okay, what is done here? Here there is a big tank. This is a main chamber. Okay. So this tank contains first impure water. Already we are sending here. Okay. There are some layers like this. There are some layers. So we put different layers here. Okay. We put here. This is gravel. We call gravel. Okay. Second part, we take one more layer of grams. Ground grams, which are smaller in size. Ground gravel, which is crushed and made into smaller size. Ground gravel. Okay. Again, this, again there is one more layer of what? Coarse sand. Sand is there. Three layers, big layers are there. It is a large tank, not small one, large tank. Okay. So here there is outlet. Again, still the water is not pure because water is contaminated and it contains many harmful microorganisms. So what we do here? There is one more tank called chlorination tank. Chlorination tank. So chlorine is one of the best disinfectant. Chlorination tank. Chlorine is one of the best disinfectant. So due to that, to remove all the germs, to kill all the germs, we use chlorine. And lastly, again there is a filter kept here. Okay. Again afterwards, there one more in big tank, we collect what? Which water? Pure water. Or called potable water. Pure or potable. What is potable? Able to drink. Water which is able to drink is potable water. So this we, this also a simple method to purify the water. So these are the different methods where we can obtain the pure substances from the impure substances, and this is economically good and economically cheaper compared to all the what purification method. Okay, so next part, I think the picture is little clear. You can refer textbook and later you come to know. Next part is physical change and chemical change. Physical change and chemical change. Okay, I think last 2 days we studied about the properties of states of matter. Okay, so physically properties you learned, what does that say? The physical property like texture, shape, size, adaptability, okay, conductivity, different properties about, physical properties about the matter you study. Okay, means there physically there is no change, and even chemical also there is no change. So physical change means what happens? The interconversion of one state of matter to another state without changing or without disturbing the, or without the changes in the physical nature as well as chemical nature of any substance. Physical nature will change, but chemical nature will not change. Okay. So physically there is some changes, but chemically the properties remain the same. One nice example. Suppose you take ice. Okay. So chemically ice, water vapor, they all are different only. They all are different, but their chemical nature is same. Means chemically they all are made up of water molecules. So in this way, the interaction conversion of physical properties will not change. Only physically they will change, but chemically they are not changed. Such a change is called physical change. Okay. Suppose you take incense stick. So burning of incense stick is both chemical and physical change. Okay. Here what is actually what means, you know, in the chemical changes. Suppose you take one paper also. I will give one more example. Paper. Okay. Small one piece of paper you take, tear it. When you tear the paper, physically they will change. Its shape may change, but chemically they are same. Okay, when you burn the papers, it forms ash, so that is chemical change. If you just tear it, that is physical change. Okay, suppose, and what these all physical or chemical properties are depending on the particles arrangement in the chemicals. So sometimes due to the properties and the chemical arrangement of the particles, there will be some changes. For example, I'll give oil and water, both are liquids. Okay, but oil is what? It will catch fire easily. It is easily inflammable. Okay. And chemically its composition different, oil. Then water is used in fire extinguishing fire. So based on their chemical properties, they have different chemical nature and they have different work also here. So in this way, chemical change means what? Means a chemical change is change where there is formation of a new substance. So whenever chemical reaction takes place, that is called a chemical change. Okay. Suppose we will perform one simple experiment to show what is physical change and chemical change. Okay. So what we do here, group 1 is, there is one group 1, group 2, okay. So you are given iron filings, what? Iron filings are given here. Here also there is iron filings. So here they give sulfur powder. Sulfur powder. Here also there is sulfur powder. So group 1 students, what they will do, they will just mix up. They will take a bowl or china dish, okay, china dish. They both mix, how? Physically. Iron filings and sulfur is mixed only physically, okay. But here what they do? They are told to heat iron filings and sulfur. They will heat in a china dish. Here also they will just mix up, mix and keep, and in here they will mix and heat. So first it is tested with magnet. You take a magnet and place over this mixture. What? Iron and sulfur mixture is there. When you hold iron over the magnet over the mixture of iron and sulfur, what happens there? Magnet attracts iron. So here we get magnet out. Iron out we get. We get here iron. But the same experiment, same magnet you take here and move over the mixture which is ready, because it is heated and kept cooled. Cooled and kept. So when you hold the magnet over the mixture of iron and sulfur which is heated, there is no change in the magnet, because magnet will not attract the substance, because it is already mixed. And here it is, there is forming a new substance which is black in color. So there is a chemical reaction of iron and sulfur. This was iron sulfide, iron sulfide. Okay, now what we do again. See, now what we'll do here, we'll take the same mixture. We'll take it and we'll perform one more simple experiment. What we'll do here, first, this will be separated in two parts. Part 1 and part 2. Part 1 and part 2. Okay. Part 2. So for this part 1, iron and sulfur is there. Okay. To this, we add iron and sulfur, okay. Actually, it is not physically combined. We add iron and sulfur here. In second, P2, what do we do here? We add acid. Iron, sulfur plus or concentrated dilute. HCl or sulfur, you can add sulfuric acid also. Okay. So to this again there is no change, because iron and sulfur we don't combine. So this forms, there is release of hydrogen, what? Hydrogen gas here. Okay. Again to this, there is no change. Here you can say there is no change. As it is, there is no mixture. Okay. So hydrogen. Okay. So we did a reaction of FeS, sulfur, hydrogen, ferrous sulfide. Okay. Which is formed by mixing iron and sulfur in the proper ratio and heated. You get ferrous sulfide. So this is made to react with dilute sulfuric acid or hydrochloric acid. This releases hydrogen gas. It releases hydrogen gas in one part. Okay. where in this part Fe plus S plus H2SO4. Here it forms what? FeSO4, and it forms hydrogen gas. FeSO4, I told part 1. This is P1. Okay, this is P2. In P2 also, here it releases hydrogen sulfide gas. In second part, it releases hydrogen gas. Okay, so in this way, there is physical change in group 1 and chemical change in group 2. Means there is no alteration in iron properties of iron, properties of sulfur when they are mixed physically. But when they are mixed chemically, they form ferrous sulfide. Okay. See, this is the reaction between the iron and sulfur where you can find the changes in physical and chemically, how they are changing. Okay. So, next part is one of the most important part here about elements. What are elements? Again, what are compounds? See, starting Robert Boyle. Robert Boyle. He used the term element. He used the term element. But later, Lavoisier. He defined actually what is element. So what is element? Element is any substance which is single form, which is having only one composition and cannot be altered, cannot be changed. Okay. So for example, gold is an element. Copper is an element. Silver is an element. Mercury is an element. So these elements, we are like this. Again, elements we divided in three types. We divide elements in three types: metals, non-metals, and metalloids. Then what are the properties of metals? First of all, you know, metals are hard in nature. Due to strong force for attraction between the particles, metals are hard in nature. Metals are lustrous, they have shining property. Metals have grey color, and metals are ductile in nature. Metals are hard in nature. Metals are bright, shiny in nature. Metals are ductile. What is ductile? Easily drawn into wires. Metals can be drawn easily into wires, thin wires. That's why they are called ductile. Malleability. They are malleable. Means they can be taken into thin sheets. Okay. Metals are sonorous. They produce sound when they are hit with any other object. Metals are sonorous. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. So due to these all, we call them as metals. Metals are almost solid in state. They are solids. But some of them are in liquid state. For example, sodium metal is hard. Metals are hard, but sodium is a metal which is soft in nature, or some of the metals are in liquid state. One example is mercury. Mercury is a metal which is in the liquid form. all the metals are hard, but only sodium is soft in nature, which can be cut like cake. Sodium is a soft metal. So these are the properties of metals. Okay, then coming to non-metals, opposite of these non-metals are properties. Okay, now non-metals are brittle in nature. They are hard, these are brittle in nature. Okay. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat and electricity. But there is exception. One is what? Graphite. Graphite is a good conductor. Non-metals are almost useful for the, because 11 numbers means out of 100%, 20% of them are non-metals, which have very important uses in our daily life. Okay, like oxygen, carbon, these are non-metals, but they have more impact on the living things. Okay. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat and electricity. Non-metals are brittle in nature. Non-metals are soft in nature. Okay, they are poor conductors. They are having industrial use. Sometimes they are used in many of the industries, non-metals. Okay. These are important properties of non-metals. And coming to, and here also I told graphite is a non-metal, which is a good conductor. Soft in nature, they are not good conductors. Okay, they are not sonorous. They are not sonorous. They are not malleable. They are not ductile. They are non-malleable or non-ductile. Okay. And almost all metals are in gaseous form or liquid form in general. 11 of them are in liquid form. Only 20% of them are non-metals. Okay. So these are the properties. But there is one more group between non-metal and metal. There is one more group called metalloid. So they have in between term intermediate properties of metal and non-metal. For example, silicon, germanium. Okay. So these are said to be metalloids. They are neither non-metals or metals. Their properties in between the metal and non-metal. They are called metalloids. Silicon is used in chips, electronic chips. Almost all mobiles are having chips. Without silicon, you cannot have the mobile. These are the important properties of metal and non-metal. Useful in, if we call softwares and not hardware, software. Okay. So metalloids are costlier compared to metal and non-metal. Okay. These are properties of metalloids. And there is one more group called alloys. Okay, alloys is a mixture of metal and metal, or metal or a non-metal, and which are present in a proper composition by mass, these are the alloys. The next we'll come to, already I give an example of iron and sulfur. Okay, so when you take iron and sulfur, physically when they combine, they are not compounds. Physically combined, they are not compounds. But when you heat them, this becomes a compound. Means chemically, the iron and sulfur are mixed in a proper ratio by mass, then it becomes a compound. So a compound is made by combination of two or more elements in a proportion by, in a proper proportion by mass. This is called compound. Now what are the difference between element and compounds? elements are single entity and compounds are made up of two or more elements. Elements cannot be physically or chemically divided. Only from elements we will get elements. But compounds can be, sometimes they may be separated by using by supplying heat energy or by chemical methods. Okay. So almost elements are useful for the internal body work, and these are also useful. Okay. Thank you.